So most of us watching this video have some kind of vocation, a job, a career, or maybe you're even an entrepreneur. Some of us love what we do, some of us absolutely hate what we do. But what most of us have in common is that at the end of the day, we do what we do in pursuit of money. This being said, if you like the type of content that I put out on this channel, you probably don't want to be enslaved to your job, your vocation, whatever the case may be, in pursuit or independence of your need for money. In this video, we're going to discuss the vocation tweaks and changes that you may need to make if you are honestly trying to pursue financial freedom. So my name is Nico and I've been a financial advisor for about 8 years now. More than this, I'm actually passionate about what I do and I love to take lessons and learn more about money, financial freedom, and how we can go about achieving this. More than this, through my occupation, I've gotten to learn how you can achieve it and how not to go about achieving it. So if financial freedom, achieving this goal, if this is something that you want to do, trust me, there's a lot more about this topic coming to this channel. So if you'd like to see more of this type of content, please don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you can be informed every time a new video comes out. Hello and welcome to the last installment of my Achieve True Financial Freedom series. If you're tuning into the channel for the first time, I strongly advise that you subscribe and give this video a like. I go back to the beginning of this series so that a lot more of what I'm talking about will make sense to you. In the first part of this series, we spoke about, we properly defined what financial freedom is not. In the second installment of this series, we looked at financial freedom and your time. In the third part of this series, we looked at financial freedom and your money. In the fourth part of this series, we looked at financial freedom and your opportunities. In the fifth part of this series, we looked at why your financial advisor cannot help you achieve financial freedom. In the sixth part of this series, we looked into the topic credit and its importance on your journey to achieving financial freedom. In this part, the last part of our series, we're going to look at financial freedom and your vocation. Right, let's get into it. So today's video is going to be a lot shorter than the other videos in this series because a lot of what we need to cover around these topics, I cover a lot more exhaustively, or will cover a lot more exhaustively in this blog. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe, give this video a like, so that you can get to see or hear more about what we'll be talking about as it relates to this topic in the future. All right, that being said, let me be clear from the very beginning, lest the topic of this video gives you a little scare. I'm not suggesting that you quit your job or that you even look into it. All I'm suggesting is that you look at your financial plan and the goals that you have for your life and the timelines that you hope to achieve these goals within, and just compare it to the career that you're in. And ask yourself a very honest question. Will the career that I'm in get me to this destination in the time that I'm hoping to get to this destination within? For example, and this is top of mind because I had a meeting with one such client today, you may have a job that offers you a prestigious job title. You know what I mean? That sounds senior, big, fancy, you know what I mean? But you're not earning as much as you could potentially be earning or could to achieve your particular goals. For example, I was speaking to one of my clients just this very afternoon, very educated, got a very nice job, nice title, but he is not earning anything considerable. All I'm suggesting is that you have a look at a couple more of my videos that cover this topic in greater depth and ask yourself the question, is the career, vocation, job that I'm in line with the goals that I have for my life? Is it one that will afford me a reasonable opportunity to pursue achieving financial freedom at a reasonable age? Look, there isn't a monolithic or panacea type of approach as it relates to kind of assessing and seeing how best to go about solving this problem. So I dare not sit here and pontificate on what would be the better route for you. If you watch this series in full, then you will know that I spoke quite extensively to some of the elements of our life that make us more fulfilled as human beings. Moreover, there are a couple more videos coming where I will delve a bit more further into the topic of your career, your income, and how this will serve or can serve towards allowing you to pursue financial freedom. The first video that I recommend you check out is a video that's already available on the channel. Are you in a job or career right now? This video is mostly about your vocation and how it relates to your fulfillment and the goals that you have for your life. Both of these, a job and a career, have their merits, and you can use either of these, job or career, to achieve financial freedom. This being said, depending on the goals that you have for your life, it may be better for you to take up a job or maybe take up a career. I don't prefer one over the other, but hopefully this gets you thinking about which one you should be in to achieve the goals that you have for your life. The second video that I recommend is a video called Types of Income Properly Defined, Passive Income Redefined. This video may not be available on the channel at the time of this upload, but will definitely soon be coming to the channel, so look out for it. And if you're not subscribed, now's a good time to subscribe so that you don't miss it when it does come through. In this video, I look at the different ways in which you can make money, how they relate to your time, and most importantly, how they relate to your journey, your goal towards achieving financial freedom. If you're looking to have a fulfilled life and maximize the time that you have available to actually enjoy your life, then this is a must-see video for you. If you're serious about achieving your financial freedom, you need to make sure that you check out this post, because this is a topic that a lot of people think about, speak about, but very few actually have a good understanding of. So, what are my final thoughts on this entire series? So, to be clear, I am still on my own personal journey towards achieving financial freedom. I know what I want for my life, and I've invested a lot of time in making sure that I do actually go about achieving this. And I've spent even more time learning exactly how to achieve financial freedom. And after years of trial and error, victory and success, observation through my own finances and through the finances of people that I respect, most importantly, the finances of my clients, I have learned the formula. These lessons, and we'll get to all of them with time, I share with you for free right here on this channel. All you need to do is smash that like button. I do not consider all of my years of practical learning to have been a waste though. I have learned so much and have so much to teach. Choosing to become a YouTuber was one of the biggest steps that I took towards achieving my financial freedom. You'll understand a lot more about what I'm talking about once you watch my video about income types. And more importantly, my other video titled Why I Became a YouTuber. I should let you know, blogging or YouTubing will not in and of itself achieve you financial freedom, but it will certainly get you there a lot quicker than other types of vocations or means of deriving income. This can definitely happen for you if you manage your money wisely and, more importantly, take heed of the lessons and the principles brought out in our previous video, Credit and Its Importance on Your Journey to Achieving Financial Freedom. While I don't believe that everything is for everybody, I certainly believe that a great number of people can either start a blog or start a YouTube channel or both. The possibilities are so vast that this creation of yours can literally become anything you want it to be. Of course, I document my personal reasons in my video, like I said, called Why I Became a YouTuber. Perhaps these reasons may resonate with you, perhaps not. If, however, you have enjoyed the sentiments of this series up to thus far, my guess is that it probably will. Well, now that we've come to the end of this series, I would like to wish you the best of luck and encourage you to actually begin your journey, begin pursuing your financial freedom. The series was just about sensitizing you, painting a picture, making you aware of what proper financial freedom looks like. Of course, for those who've subscribed, we're going to get into this topic in a lot more granular detail. I'm going to equip you with much more granular advice and, of course, ideas, methodology, solutions, so that you can begin to pursue your financial freedom today. If there are any topics in particular that you would like me to address, please let me know in the comments. Also, let me know what you thought about this series, if there's any questions that you had that I did not answer in the series, and I will be sure to either respond to you in the comments or put out a video that will look at this topic in much more granular detail. Thank you for staying with me in this series and watching it until the very end. Do enjoy the rest of the day. I will see you in the next video. Peace. So I've been running my financial planning practice for about 8 years now. So I've been thoroughly exposed to all the methods that work and all the methods that don't work. And as an extension of this YouTube channel, I've also now started to consult one-on-one, helping you with wealth coaching. We talk everything from credit, how to speak to your banks, buying cars, property investment, everything you need to know so that you can achieve financial freedom successfully. If you want to get in touch and schedule a consultation, contact me via the email provided in the description.